Hey guys, this is going to be day 15 of the Clownfish Babies. Today I'm going to show you a view of what I do when I change the water on the clownfish. Also, I wanted, because a lot of you have asked me, show a video on what you do to change the water and how it's done. So this is what I'm going to do today. It's going to be a bit far away, just to show you an overview of what's going on. And then after I'm done with the changing of the water, I'm going to show you guys the clownfish on a close-up a bit. They have gotten a bit bigger, so I will show you that. So first of all, I'm going to show you what I do to change the water. First of all, I'm going to get some rigid airline tubing. This is the same tubing that you use for the RODI system. I use this because I noticed that with this one, it's easier to reach the bottom and scrape off all the nutrients from the bottom of the tank, and it's easier to control. It's not as flimsy as the other airline tubing. So here we go. I start the siphon. Siphon going. After that, I just go with the airline tubing and make sure I don't catch any fish. And just siphon off the bottom, the bad nutrients, everything that's the debris that's in the bottom. All that needs to come out. Just be very careful when you do this, because you really don't want to catch any fish. It's really hard to put them back in the tank once you siphon them off into the bucket or anything. There you go, as you can see, I'm grabbing all the debris from the bottom. The fish right now are pretty strong. They will get away from the tube, and they will swim away if they feel like they are getting sucked into it. But I don't know, today they seem a bit more friendly and they want to get closer to it for some reason. I keep doing this until I can get as much as I can out. You don't want to keep any of this bad stuff in here. Tends to collect on the bottom, and also starting to get a lot of coral and algae in here. And it's kind of strange since the tank is so small, but I guess water parameters are pretty good. I get the water in this tank from my main reef tank, so that's probably where it got transferred. And since the light on this tank is on 24/7, it creates a good foundation for the coralline algae to grow. I do about 20 to 30% water change on this. I did a lot of it before I started the video, just to speed up the video process and not show you guys everything. It's the same thing, just a longer process. Just wanted to show you guys what I do to do this. Also, I'm gonna try to siphon up some of the hair algae that's growing on this live rock right here. It's kind of hard to get sucked up. They stick really well to the rock. Also, I have a lot of debris here too, but it's kind of hard to get those out. Clownfish don't want to go away from it. And I really don't want to suck up any of them. that's about it. After I do this, I just check the bucket just in case I did suck up a fish by mistake or anything. And I try to put it back. There it is. Now I'm gonna take the siphon hose out and then go get replacement water from my main tank. Okay, I just got back from the main tank with some of the fresh water. Just wanted to show you guys, I just put it in. Just like that. And there you got it. That's what I do to change my water. I do this every day. It ensures that the water conditions are good in the tank and that the fish are nice and healthy. And I'm gonna put back the lid right now. It's because the air stone kicks up a lot of bubbles and it gets all over the place. Now I'm gonna show you a close-up of what my fish look like. Day 15. And that's how they're doing. They're doing pretty well. You can start seeing how clownfishy they are. They're doing really, really well. Also, I wanted to show you guys my new setup. My clowns hatched again 2 days ago, and I wanted to show you what I did. I basically used the same light I had before, but I separated over the two tanks, and I just built a little rigged up light stand right there with some extra wood I had. And I just put the new tank next to it. I had all the equipment and everything from what I've been using. All I needed to do is just get the new 10-gallon tank and put the new hatched fry in it. I'm using the same air pump. I just added a new air stone to the new one. And that's what's going on with my clownfish and how everything's doing. If you guys have any other questions, please let me know. Also, I'm glad that you guys asked me to do this video because shows me that you guys are interested in what I do, and shows me that you guys are interested in actually trying to breed clownfish yourself, and that's pretty great. Please let me know in the comments if you guys need any other videos, and I will see you guys later. Bye.